Goodell, if he didn't know what was on that tape, he's a liar. I'm just saying it. He is lying. I think that dude is lying. If you put him up on a lie detector test, that guy would fail. And, for he's all these people to pretend they didn't know is such f***ing bullshit. It really is. It's such f***ing bullshit.
ESPN decided to suspend Bill Simmons, who is one of its biggest and highest profile stars, for 3 weeks after essentially he called Roger Goodell, the commissioner of the NFL, a liar. ESPN took issue with that. Another problem, I think, for ESPN was the rant had several profane words in it. Remember that ESPN is owned by Disney. They especially took issue with the fact that he dared them essentially to suspend him, to punish him in some way.
I really hope somebody calls me or emails me and says I'm in trouble for anything I say about
Roger
Goodell.
No, I don't. I think it's pretty safe.
If one person says that to me, I'm going public. You leave me alone.
We
may have to bleep. The commissioner's a liar, and I get to talk about that on my podcast. Please call me and say I'm in trouble. I dare you.
One of the questions that looms in everyone's mind is whether the NFL pressured ESPN after this podcast in which Bill Simmons called Roger Goodell a liar. You know, ESPN has a relationship with the NFL. Obviously, it's a multi-billion dollar investment. ESPN is considered by the NFL to be a broadcast partner. And typically, the NFL is known to give ESPN a call when there's something it doesn't like. ESPN is independent. It doesn't always respond to that. But it seems incomprehensible that there probably wouldn't have been a little reminder there that, we could probably take our NFL games, our Monday Night Football game, to any other network, maybe even to the internet.